Yes, this is a video about keyboards, IBM keyboards to be specific, because recently I got in a little bit of a discussion with somebody on Reddit about whether or not it is true that IBM Model F keyboards have N key rollover. Rollover is the ability of a keyboard to detect more than one key press at a time, for example holding down multiple keys, and it's expressed as either a number or the letter N. A number would be a specific limit to the number of keys that can be detected as being pressed simultaneously, or N represents whatever the maximum number of keys on your keyboard is. That is to say, there is no fixed limit to the amount of keys that can be depressed at one time and be recognized by the computer. Rollover is not normally an issue for typing, because even a two-key rollover is more than enough to handle the occasional times when you may hit more than one key at a time. For example, as you're typing fast, you may push the next key while you're still letting go of the first key. So there's always a little bit of tolerance for that built into the keyboard, so it wouldn't miss any key presses in normal typing. But for gaming, it can become an issue, because you may be pushing multiple keys down at a time, and if you reach your keyboard's rollover limit, it will ignore any further key presses, and that will put you at a disadvantage in your game. So that's why gamers prefer a keyboard with N key rollover, because no matter how many keys they're mashing down at a time, the computer will not ignore their key presses. So first I'll try out this IBM Model M keyboard, which is known to have two key rollover. I'm using it with this little compact Despro EN. It's a Pentium 3. Running Windows XP, obviously. This is actually a slot 1 Pentium 3. It's probably the smallest computer I've ever seen use a slot 1 CPU. I guess I haven't run Malwarebytes in a long time on this computer. So I found this program called Aqua's Key Test. And its purpose is to show the keys that you're pressing on the keyboard, which gives you a visual representation. And you can see if I push down more than one key at a time, it shows up on the screen. So you can see the different patterns I can push down. And if you're a gamer, one of the most important key combinations you're going to be using is the WASD. That you use to move around. So if I try to push WASD at the same time, you can see I'm holding down ASD, I'm trying to push W, and it's not registering. In fact, we can hear a beep. So that's the limitation of the rollover on this keyboard. I can't push down WASD all at the same time. I can push down other combinations of the keys at the same time. So you can get 8 keys there on different sides of the keyboard. But if I try to push Q, W, E, R, and T, the T is not recognized, and we get the beeping again. So there's a certain limit to the number of keys I can hold down and have the computer recognize. So that's why I can get 4 on one side and 4 on the other side, no problem. If I try to get 5 all in a row, doesn't like that. Likewise, doesn't like that either. So this is the limitation of a keyboard that does not have N key rollover. And I also tried an IBM Model M2, that's the slimline version that was used in the PS1, as well as an Acer mechanical keyboard, as well as the keyboards that are built into my IBM ThinkPad T20 and Lenovo ThinkPad X60, and they all behave the same as this. They all have this same limitation of the number of keys that can be pressed simultaneously. So now I switched over to the IBM Model F keyboard, and yes, I know the program on the screen is showing the incorrect layout, but it still works the same. So now we can repeat the same test. And this time, if I hold down WASD, you can see they're all being registered and it's not beeping. And in fact, I can keep going. I can hold down pretty much the entire keyboard, and there's no limit to the number of keys that I can push. I mean, it's obviously limited to the number of keys on the keyboard, so when Wikipedia says it's infinite key rollover, it's not really infinite. In this case, it's 84 key rollover, because that's the number of keys this keyboard has. But that's kind of pointless, because who's going to do that? You only have 10 fingers unless you start typing with something else while you're using your fingers. So in reality, the most you're ever going to need is 10 key rollover. That's where you can have all 10 fingers pushing the keys and everything you push is being recognized. So I can push WASD on this side, and I can push keys on the other side, and everything is being recognized. So I think this should be conclusive proof that the Model F has N key rollover. And another way to test it is on Microsoft's website. They have a thing called keyboard ghosting demonstration, and it does the same thing. So you can see I can hold down multiple keys and sometimes it complains. Now I plugged in one of these Apple Chiclet keyboards, and if I try to hold down WASD, it only recognizes a maximum of 3 of those key presses at a time. So this keyboard is obviously not N key rollover.
I could go through the rest of my keyboard collection, and believe me, I have quite a few more keyboards, but I think most would behave the same as these keyboards, where only a certain number of keys can be pushed at a time, and the Model F is the exception, which has N key rollover, because that's an inherent trait of the capacitive key switches it uses. Man, check out this cable in comparison to the little cable of the Apple keyboard. And here's that adapter I used to connect it, which has the large 5-pin DIN connector to a standard PS2 keyboard port back there next to the PS2 mouse. And like I said, this is not something that people will normally notice in everyday typing. It's really only something that would make a difference to gamers. And since I mentioned it, I took off the cover of this compact so we can release this drive cage. And there you can see the slot 1 CPU lying flat against the motherboard. There is that built-in speaker and the RAM. And we can remove this cage, and we can see this thing has 2 PCI slots and 1 16-bit ISA slot. So you can put an ISA sound card or anything else in here. So this is a really nice little computer. I actually have a wireless card in here, although I didn't have an antenna connected to it, so I was just using Ethernet to connect to that website. And this has ATI RagePro Turbo AGP 3D graphics on the motherboard, and there's the video RAM, so it can be upgraded. So this is a very neat little system. This is the older Compact Desk Pro EN before they... You don't see that many of these. It even has a laptop-style CD-ROM drive, while the later Desk Pro ENs had a standard 5.25-inch drive bay. And this thing still has its original factory-equipped MacStore 6.4GB hard drive, and it only has one reallocated sector. Otherwise, it works perfectly.
Here's how to remember it. Computers often make people quite angry.
John?
See? Computers often make people quite...